manufacturing plant. So basically the problem statement for this project was the seating manufacturing that was a partner for the Toyota company, and overall operations or improvement of the operations of the Toyota manufacturing company. It is basically I don't need to give any disclaimer. Toyota is basically a Japanese company, and it started its new plant in the new trainway. So the objectives of this project would be to develop and enhance the new techniques of the production, and to reduce the overall cost of the production and the time of the production. The deliverables were to implement the just-in-time theory, and to develop a system, a whole system to for the production of Camry and the wagons. So the further will be taken care of by Ethan.
So this is the root cause analysis. So the main issue as discussed by Vajid is seat issue when they are installing the seat which they are getting from their seat supplier, that is Kentucky Frame Seat. So during assembly there is some issue, that is the hook issue due to which the seats are getting damaged. The other causes of it are product proliferation, response time, that is within 50 seconds they have to install the seat in the Camry model of the car, and the braking hook, as I have discussed, and the KFS could not supply a replacement for defective seats. So this is the project charter. So the project, as mentioned, is Toyota Motor Manufacturing Incorporation, which was created by a general manager and sponsored by its subsidiary Toyota Motor Corporation Japan. So the project initiated in 1985, and the statement of our project is the facilitating the production ramp up of Camry wagon model. So the goal statement is supplying 240,000 of Camry wagon model, and objective is application of TPS, increasing production of car, reducing the overtime cost and scope. We will be further discussing scope analysis in the further slides, and deliverables have been discussed by Vajit. These are the project milestones. We got 8 milestones in our project, which has been mentioned year wise, initiated from 1985 till execution of 1992. Roles and responsibilities of the project was, the project team were from the internal structure of the company. We had Fujiyoshi, the president, general manager of assembly plant, and quality control from quality control department. Whereas for key stakeholders, we had the TMC from Japan, KFC, supplier of seat, car sellers and car buyers. Scope analysis will be discussed by
Rajan. So the scope analysis of the whole project is divided into 5 different parts. We'll be taking care of the objectives, the goals, in scope and out scope. So the project was initiated with the objective of cost reduction basically of the overall production, and the decreasing the waste overall, because it was analyzed that there was a lot of waste that is happening, and because of that there was a cost that was incurred on it. And more of, there would be the right time, right car has to be delivered. That's a mix. Next is the goals. So the main goal of this project was to develop a system on the whole plant with the capacity of 2 lakh products every year, and 240,000 Camrys every year. The phases, the total production, basically the construction of the plant is divided into 3 phases. So the trim lines and the chassis lines, the development of it and the execution of these lines, then the final assembly lines of the whole plant, powertrain line and the paint line, the painting of the car. So in scope was to develop and execute the whole assembly line, manufacturing unit and the quality check of the whole, the cars, the products. The out scope, which was not, discovered in our research, was basically designing the unit of the market research to develop a new product and more of the DMS system for the dealers and the distributors, and the marketing and the research of it. Next.
So this is the work breakdown structure of Toyota Motor Manufacturing. So we have made our work breakdown structure through the project life cycle basis, from initiation, planning, execution and monitoring and control. So initiation, what we have done is risk analysis, constraint analysis, and whereas in planning and designing, hiring and development, hiring of manpower, production capacity, and further it is discussed about the process which they are applying is just in time manufacturing, Jidoka, Kaizen and Toyota production system. Execution is we have an execution three phase where we have plant assembly of plant, production engineering as well as so here we have chassis line, trim line, plastic molding. So what we have done in our project is apart from the problem of slit issue, we have taken as a overall project for construction of project each department wise, and then we are giving the solution how to solve for the slit issue. In monitoring and controlling, we have application of Toyota production system which consists of Kaizen, Hejunka, Jidoka, and we have QC engineers which are there in our assembly line system which are looking over the quality control. So actually we have made out this network diagram with the all the work breakdown structures. So all the activities of work breakdown structures have been converted into different units, and then each time is given for each activity, and accordingly we found our critical path method as shown by yellow dots. Can you go to Gantt chart? So these were the activities which have been mentioned here. Those with start date and end date, can you go on the top side? These are the start date and end date with the duration. This has been used for critical path method, and same has been used for drawing the Gantt chart. We can say this is for the product life cycle, from initiation, scope analysis, constraint analysis, then production of planning, human resources, and at the end execution. This is the risk breakdown structure for WPS. So for each stage, technical, external, organizational and project management, we have the issue of assembly line failure, and we have human resource issue in organization, training of manpower which is being required to deliver the project in right time. As well as in project management, we have deviation from there was an issue where we were deviating from Jidoka and just in time. So these were the issues in the risk breakdown structure. Next will be explained by Akansha.
So this is a risk severity table. So basically, this risk severity table took all the activities from the work breakdown structure. So all these activities are again divided into some risks. In this, we have four phases, that is initiation phase, planning, execution and monitoring and control. So in all these phases, what are the risks associated with this, I have written. So this is likelihood, and its likelihood is basically the chances of occurring the event. And next is weightage, and next is impact. Impact means how severe it will be if the activity, if the risk for an activity occurs. So for calculating CLF, I have multiplied weightage into likelihood, and for calculating CIF, I have multiplied impact into weightage. So we'll be getting the values. I have added values according to the like phase. In the initiation phase, there are two risks basically. So I have added that, and I have found out the severity, and in the same way I have calculated for each and every risk. So here the red means the risk is severe. So that is a major risk. So if we have to take steps in order to reduce the risk, and yellow means minor risk. So we can take steps to reduce the risk after we are done with the red one. So and the green means the minor. one. So if the like we can actually like avoid that risk. So if only the project status of that particular risk changes, so accordingly we have to take steps. So this is all about risk severity table, and this is a matrix. So based on the risk, I have given the numbers. These numbers are like they are more clear in the Excel. So on the risks, what fall under green, yellow, and red, I have mentioned. So next comes is RACI. RACI, basically depending upon the milestones, I have made this RACI that I have divided into phase 1, 2, 3 and 4. So for those things, who is responsible, I have given the roles and accordingly I have pointed out who is responsible, who is consulted, who is informed and who is accountable for it.
So the second project for us is the Bhopal DRTS project, or we will call it DDRTS. So the problem statement here was the traffic congestion and the transportation problem which the Bhopal city was facing. The background note here was there was a very much traffic congestion, and for the urban development of the city, DRTS project is the most feasible one, available for at that time. The objectives for the project were to develop the whole route mapping, the trip times and the buses, how many routes.
Now talk about objectives. The objective of the project was to reduce the trip time of the passengers from traveling from Bhairavgarh to Mero, which was the main corridor, main stretch of the corridor. Next was to reduce the operating cost for the buses, and there was also option of introducing a metro railway, but it was more cost efficient to introduce the BRT system compared to the metro line, because of the overhead cost required in the planning and the implementation of the metro line. Furthermore, to reduce the mixed traffic impacts and to increase the service reliability, and to generate the further growth options for the municipal corporation of the Bhopal, and to achieve an universal design which can be implemented and incorporated into different other cities as well. As was the case of Ahmedabad BRTS, which was again implemented in Delhi but failed utterly. So the deliverables of the project are to provide an uninterrupted transport facility across the longest stretch between Bhairavgarh and Mysore of the corridor, to construct 48 ultra-modern stoppage stations across the entire stretch of 44 kilometers, to construct park and ride facilities across the state, across the stations, to help the passengers to avail the ride facilities, and to have a standardized fare which was not present earlier in case of the public bus transport in Bhopal, to have a scheduled departure and arrival time and reduce the delay time of the BRTS system, and to develop a complementary bus services which would connect different points in the city with BRTS station. This is basically, there would be a main corridor and there would be a service lane along which the different buses would be plying, which would connect the main corridor with different stops in the city.
This is the root cause analysis. The problem is we have inefficient public transport system in Bhopal. The causes for it is severe congestion, improper lack of traffic control and regulation, high growth rate of vehicle and concentration of activities in the core areas of the city. This is the project charter. So it is a PPP model, based on PPP model, public-private partnership model. So it is funded by BMC, Bhopal Municipal Corporation, and government, central government as well as state government. Objective is to have improved effective public transport system and offer comfortable ride. In scope and out scope we will explain it later on. Deliverables have been explained. So these are the milestones. Here also the project was initiated in 2006 and was executed in 2016. In between that we have taken 8 milestones. And roles and responsibilities of key stakeholders, the Government of India, Madhya Pradesh, Railway authorities, all are the key stakeholders, and project team within the organizations are BMC, BCLL and private operators and third party agency for quality and organs. Title, go to 20 minutes.
Okay.
So this project also we have done in project life cycle according to project life cycle. So initiation, planning, execution, monitoring and controlling. So same in initiation we did all the risk analysis, constraint analysis, scope analysis, whereas in planning, hiring of manpower, detailed planning, survey regarding the area, study of topography, as well as in monitoring and execution, there were third parties were given for execution and audit was done and supervision was done by BMC. In monitoring and control, there was the main communication which was looked over. It was one of the risk also. So transparency in the system was also looked on for the so that there is a smooth process of communication among each different departments. So, can you open the Excel? Oh, different, this is the VRTS. VRTS. So, these were taken out from the work breakdown structure with start date and end date, and then it was converted to the Gantt chart, and the same similar was used in making of critical path method. As you can see, these are the parallel activities which are going on during the our planning phase. For an example, BRT vehicle configuration style, intelligent system, these all were the system which they were planning to install in it. And can you go to the CPM? So these were the same activities, and then the critical path method has been shown with the yellow dots. This is the risk breakdown structure for each technical, physical, technical, external risk, organization, project management. So the risk which are, so the risk are, for an example, the communication system. If there is no communication system among the different department, this can lead to the failure of the project, because each department has to be approached for approval of different tenders. And in external risk, we have approval as well as delay in creating project, land acquisition, or this thing, difficulty in removing encroachment. These were all the external risks. Organizational risk was the lack of proper training was given. So for that, the proper training was to be given to different drivers. So can you move to EVA? Open the Excel file of EVA. So, no, the semi-annual. So we had the three phases: initiation, planning, and execution. So for each phase, we have done semi-annually. For an example, my initiation is completing in 2 years. So for 2 years, 1 year for two phases, and then another year for two phases. So each phase wise, I have taken, for an example, the first activity is being completed. Not activity, this is a milestone. So connected with the milestone. So the first milestone which is being completed from 2006 to 2007. So in 2006 to 2007, 2006 and semi-annually, and then 2007 semi-annually. So each, and then planned completion, actual completion percentage, BAC, all have been calculated. And the negative sign which has been shown where in CV shows that the task is over budgeted, and the one in which yellow which is shown is that the task is behind schedule. So for an example, the activity A, first phase is over budgeted, whereas same activity under schedule variance, it's coming negative. So it's also behind the schedule. Can you explain this? So I will call Rahul for explaining this.
I will be talking about the business continuity plan or the disaster recovery plan. The main purpose of the BCP is to ensure the continuation of the business in case and following a critical incident which might disrupt the business activities. So four major elements of the business continuity plan are preparedness, prevention, recovery, and